Turn your phones off. And charge your glasses, because you're going to have to drain them at the end. First of all, welcome to this beautiful establishment. The second time I've ever been on the roof of I don't even know what it is, but I'm on the roof drinking grog, so it's a new night for all of us here. My name's Mark Rachel, for those of you who I haven't met yet. I'm MC, and it's my job to first of all, welcome everybody this evening. I'm going to welcome six different groups of people here this evening. The first of which are those people like Greg, who have been born with IA. I believe there's some of you in the house. I'd also like to specifically welcome Greg's family, Max, who I've seen, Wendy, who I... Yeah, here, get around. Hang on together for the Ryan family. Max, Wendy, Brad, Hannah, I believe Archer and Jack as well. If you've read the book, you understand how wonderful they have been in support of their young men. I want to highlight, speaking of family, all the North Melbourne people here in the house, and I reckon there's nearly a third of us. All of us have admired Greg's work over years, but really not many, if any, knew what his secret was. So I'm sure I'm speaking on his behalf. He's asked me to be here. So on his behalf, thank you for all of you from Marvin Street coming tonight. I also want to thank the medical fraternity. You're going to meet one of them in a little while. They and they alone really understand the physical and the mental dimension to Greg's story. All his friends are here and may not have been able to understand or penetrate his secret. And there are a handful of members of the media here, and we're really pleased that you're here. We'd like you to shout the story from the rooftops in a sensitive manner, and because this impacts 1 in 5,000 people, so it's rare. My link to Greg is not particularly interesting, but I'll tell it to you anyway. Mine was a brief and inglorious career at Arden Street as a footballer, and when I arrived in the early 90s, I met Greg. And I knew straight away, you know, he's a friendly guy, and we shared an interest in history, and he will tell you everything you've ever needed to know about the club, and in particular, the interview he shared with Essendon. Anyway, I just sort of warmed with him, but it's fair to say, there was always some sort of reservation, and we stayed in touch when I left, and I knew he had his ups and downs. Anyway, not long ago, he rang me and said, Sticks, I'd like to come and see you, I've written a book, and I thought to myself, boy, that was not quite the word, there were two words here, so I won't swear. The world needs another book about North Melbourne, like a whole group of 10. He wanted to come around, and I'm sure he wanted to talk about the footy club and the ebbs and flows of it all. And look, for those of you who don't know, North's a small club, and I wasn't sure the market was going to justify his enthusiasm. But anyway, he sat down and bang, hit me between the eyes with his story, and I read it. I read it in a week, I know, it was a couple of sittings over the weekend, and I rang him afterwards and I congratulated him on it for a number of reasons, none the least of which was such a compelling story, my God. And then I found myself standing back and saying, good on him, my friend Greg has had his chest out, and I know he's a pioneer, and it's given his life a purpose, and he's demonstrably a different bloke, and to think, without spoiling it, I know John Lamont and one or two others are going to buy the book and haven't yet read it, or in fact don't know the story, but I will let you into one little secret that Greg is now an accomplished public speaker in front of hundreds of people in an international forum, and believe it or not, that's true. And I suppose that was the thing that struck me most of all, that he's gone from this guy that was a shy fellow who is now no longer. Today, by the way, is World Mental Health Day, the 10th of October. The World Health Authority have designated it, and I don't think it's a coincidence that we're here on this day, because mental health has obviously been a challenge Greg's had to deal with, and I was just speaking to one of our speakers, and it's synonymous with this aberration. So I think it's a really good fit that we're here on this day, and I think it's appropriate to sort of recognise that. And in my little, 1 in 5 Australian adults will have some sort of mental health challenge this year. And 47% of us are going to get it at some stage or another. And I've had some experience arm's length with a few mates that you just can't believe they can't function because of it. So I think it's important. Enough of me.